Présentant tout d'abord dans le coin bleu, introducing first in the blue corner. He weighed in at 134.5 pounds, wearing black, trimmed with white. His professional record, 10 wins with 3 wins coming by way of knockout in 17 outings as a professional. De Toulon, France, Sébastien Benito. His opponent in the red corner, he went in at a solid 134.7 pounds. His professional record, 8 wins with 6 wins coming by way of knockouts in 9 outings as a professional. From Toronto, Ontario, ladies and gentlemen, Brahim Firearm Kamal.
Boxer, you both receive my instruction in the locker room. I want a good, clean fight. Protect yourself at all time. Touch gloves. Good luck, both of you.
We are set to go. 6 rounds in the lightweight division. Both men coming in under the lightweight limit of 135. And both men coming off impressive performances. I mentioned Benito going the distance with a former world title challenger and Kevin Mitchell last time out. And Kamal with what should have been a knockout victory changed to a no contest in Nicaragua. Lots of controversy there. It was said that Kamal was using sugar water in the corner for some reason, and they took his knockout win over him. Took his knockout win away from him, excuse me. Nonetheless, most people know what really happened over there. Second round knockout win for Kamal in that one. Round one scheduled for 6. Kamal, the southpaw, in the white trimmed with black. Benito in black trimmed with white. Kamal with a reputation for a pair of fast hands, and there he catches Benito early. A cuffing left hand. Kamal going downstairs right away. Corner man Mike Moffitt telling him to take his time, but Benito is giving him the opportunity to tee off. Kamal, as you heard in the introductions, from Toronto. Born in Toronto, but spent his childhood in Libya, then moved back to Southern Ontario, where he started his boxing career at the age of 11. A highly decorated one, as mentioned. And truly one of the nicest people that you'll meet in boxing. He and his wife, Miranda, run the MJKO Foundation, which reaches out to youths in Southern Ontario through the sport of boxing. And plenty of good work outside of the ring as well. And Kamal was tripped up on the feet of Benito there a moment ago. And Benito sneaks in a right hand there of his own. Benito's had some success domestically as well. He reached the semifinals of the French lightweight tournament that was put on a couple years ago before dropping a decision to a 5-0 prospect. He proved himself very sturdy against Kevin Mitchell last time out. Had some trouble with Mitchell's hand speed, which you can see he's having with Kamal here tonight again. Not a lot of head movement, but manages to stand in there and give guys rounds. Final 20 seconds of round one. Left hand just misses from Kamal once again. Short uppercuts from Benito on the inside, but a very good opening round for Ibrahim Kamal. Come on, let's go. Let's go. Hello. Come on. some of the action from round one. Kamal, then he got a big shot early on. Had Benito in some trouble in the opening minute of this bout. Benito settled down as the round went on and actually was able to sneak in a few shots of his own. Very much an Ibrahim Kamal round. Round two now. See if Kamal can get off to a fast start the way that he did in round one. And there, good quick combination upstairs. Kamal's only been taking the distance twice in his career, and once was against Mauricio Goico, who we referenced earlier on in the broadcast, who gave Mick Gadbois a little bit of trouble and went the distance with Tony Lewis last time out here on Fight Network. Well, using his jab a little bit more in this round. Coach Mike Maffo is imploring him to do so in the first. Straight left from Kamal to Benito, says lands behind the head, and there, another straight left. And you see the hand speed from Kamal. He whips that uppercut and comes right back with a right hook. You need a pair of fast hands to make that combination work. Benito took the aforementioned Kevin Mitchell fight on some short notice and still managed to go the distance. Ooh, good left hook there from Benito. I think Kamal knows that he's still in here. Back to the jab is Kamal at the advice of his trainer. Final 30 seconds left here in round two. A left from Kamal, but immediately a straight right in reply from Benito. A lot of volume and a lot of good work from Kamal, but couple eye-catching punches from Benito as well. Some of the action from round two. A more competitive round two. Kamal boxing and moving from the outside, but Benito sneaking in a couple good shots of his own. There, a right hand in reply. Not surprising whatsoever. We knew what we were getting in Benito, a sturdy guy. Been able to stand in there with some world-class talent. And that's what's been projected for Kamal. As we mentioned, an extremely decorated amateur whose pro career hasn't been able to get moving maybe the way he envisioned. And now co-promoted by Eye of the Tiger Management. Doing the majority of his training in Montreal, and there's a check right hook, and down goes Benito. Benito briefly pleads that it might have been a slip, but that was a clean knockdown. Well, not rushing in. Knows that was more of a timing shot. Again, the hand speed making a big difference here in this one. Another good left hand from Kamal. He's been able to throw some combinations that Benito's not likely used to seeing. Quick left hand there again by Kamal. Again, he'll throw that uppercut downstairs and come back with a hook. You won't find too many trainers that'll teach you to throw that, but if you have fast enough hands, you can make it work. Kamal showing some good head movement here, getting out of the way of Benito's jabs. Kamal just touching Benito at every opportunity. Ooh, another left hand staggers Benito. Kamal still taking his time. A good measured approach from Kamal, who is putting on a defensive clinic here in this round as well. Very smooth and impressive round from Firearm here in round three. We come to the final 10 seconds. A dominant round for Ibrahim Kamal. Shots to the body, with that straight left. And Benito was barely able to touch Kamal throughout round three. Ducking and moving, just simple head movement. Kamal proving very evasive on top of that offensive ability that he has. Fall short with that left hand. We move into round four. Benito now just walks himself into the corner. There's another right hook, catches Benito falling in, and that will be another knockdown. Yeah, not necessarily hurting Benito on those two knockdowns. But when you get hit with a shot that you don't see, that could be the result. And oh my goodness, Benito clobbers Kamal with a left hook. And Kamal is in some serious danger. The referee taking a long look at Kamal, who went down and appeared out of it. He's just trying to hold on and get out of this round. Benito tags him again. Oh my. Kamal might be too brave for his own good. Now trying to hold on, but his instincts are to stand and trade. Now Kamal comes back. a two-punch combination, but his legs still don't seem to be there, and down goes Kamal again. A shocking turn of events as Benito comes in on the road and has Kamal down twice here in the fourth round. A big right hand, and the referee steps in, and that is it. Sebastian Benito with a monstrous upset over a blue chip prospect here from Canada. Unbelievable. Just when it looked like Sebastian Benito was utterly outclassed, this happened. A massive left hook. And another straight right hand sends Kamal to the canvas. Absolutely shocking. There was no way of predicting this. Excitement in Benito's corner. Nobody here expected him to win, but he certainly felt he could do something like this. What an upset. Kamal with two knockdowns on Benito, and Benito rallies back. There you see the beginning of the end for Kamal once again. Let's get you up to Pierre Bernier to make this upset official.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 2:03 of the fourth round as the referee stops the contest. The winner by TKO, Sebastian Benito.
Sebastian Benito, your winner by technical knockout. A big upset here in Gatineau. Taking out Ibrahim Kamal when it looked like he was outclassed. A pair of knockdowns from Kamal.